corner and towards Conrod Strait again. Everything going so superbly for Tom Walkinshaw. First class operation, and first class has put him right up at the front of the field in qualifying yesterday. We take race cam out of Tom's Jaguar. As he comes down, that's our camera, our speed camera, over the centre of Conrod Strait on Mt Panorama. Just look at the speed difference between Tom's Jaguar and some of the slower cars. You can't really call them slow.
Haven't seen any slower cars. There's nobody inside. He's got it on his own at the moment. Down through the gears, Walkinshaw into the braking area. The bottom of Conrod Strait, left hand about the straight. Look at the crowd on the hill there, just by Hardy Bridge. As Walkinshaw flattens the big V12 again and heads off on another circuit of Mt Panorama. Six laps down.
And he's got a 4.5 second gap over Robbie Francevic in the Volvo number 55. The gap from Francevic back to Dick Johnson is 4.3 seconds. And then about half a second separates Johnson from Brock, with still Jim Richards in hot pursuit.
Some of the slower traffic now, you can see, and Walkinshaw just flicks straight past.
Coming up on one of the Toyotas.
The under 2 litre, smaller capacity cars, of course, are not in contention for any outright honours here at Mt Panorama today. John Smith at the wheel of one of them, but circulating wisely and safely, we hope, particularly with the brute strength of the Jaguars touring Mt Panorama the way they are at the moment. Walkinshaw working at the wheel through Toledo Turn across the top of the mountain now at Castrol and McPhillamy Park. Coming on to Skyline. And now dropping down towards the S's. Spectacular part of the circuit, a hard-working part of the circuit.
This is the car from Western Australia, car number 23, the Simon Emmeling Trevor Hine BMW that he's just gobbled up. Working very hard, and watch him as he comes down Conrod Strait, so quick on the gear shift.
Well, Tom Walkinshaw continues.